Welcome back to my Dutch reaction channel. My name is John and I am from Australia. And as the title or my channel kind of suggests, and I said the start of video, reacting to Dutch videos from Netherlands. Well, this one I saw today, I saw the title just now and I'm like, okay, I need to do a video on this one. More reactions are going to be coming from now. You might see my background and this room I'm in is a little different to my other videos. So that's given me just a bit more a fresh environment and ready to get more videos recorded. But as I said, I found, this one seemed really interesting off the title. It says, the Netherlands, the country that shouldn't exist but does. I'm interested to see the perspective. Like, why shouldn't they exist? So we get this in 4K. And for those of you that are Dutch, and you, if you live in the Netherlands, let me know how accurate this ends up being, the information. Because, the title grabbed my interest. Let's get right into it.
Here's a fascinating fact. One third of the Netherlands technically shouldn't exist. It's literally below sea level. Yet this small...
We've gone from the country that shouldn't exist to one third. In how quick was that? In the first second? That's all right.
The Netherlands technically shouldn't exist. Here's a fascinating fact. One third of the Netherlands technically shouldn't exist.
One third.
It's literally below sea level. Yet this small country has managed to become one of the world's most prosperous nations. The second largest agricultural exporter on earth. Yes, really. And a global center for innovation and trade. A place where...
Yeah, I learned that from some other videos that I did before. Letting me know how how much Netherlands really is involved with. And the work they do like that.
On earth. Yes, really. And a global center for innovation and trade.
A
place where you'll find more bikes than people. Where the tallest mountain is 322 meters high. And where pragmatism has been elevated to an art form. This is the Netherlands, the low country with high ambitions. The Netherlands sits in northwestern Europe, acting as the delta where some of Europe's mightiest rivers meet the North Sea. It's bordered by Germany to the east, Belgium to the south, and the North Sea to the northwest. At 41,543 square kilometers, roughly twice the size of New Jersey or about the same as Switzerland, the Netherlands has somehow become one of the world's most densely populated yet livable countries. The country consists of 12 provinces, with North and South Holland being the most famous. And yes, that's why people incorrectly call the whole country Holland. It's like calling the United States California. The Netherlands has 451 kilometers of North Sea coastline. But here's where it gets interesting. If you include all the islands, estuaries, and the former Zuider Zee, now the IJsselmeer Lake, the total coastline stretches much further. The country is essentially a massive river delta, where the Rhine, Meuse, and Scheldt rivers empty into the sea. 26% of the country is below sea level, with the lowest point being 6.76 meters below sea level near Rotterdam. Another 29% is less than 1 meter above sea level.
Wow.
Without its elaborate system of dikes, pumps, and barriers,
our worst fears that we've been warning about have come true. A famine is occurring in Gaza City.
Just a little ad popped up here, so we'll skip that.
About half the above sea level. Without its elaborate system of dikes, pumps, and barriers, about half the country would be underwater twice a day at high tide. The Dutch didn't just adapt to their geography, they completely rewrote it. The Netherlands is flatter than a pancake. The highest point, the Valserberg in Limburg, reaches a whopping 322.4 meters. That's not even a proper hill by most standards, but the Dutch proudly call it a mountain. The country is dominated by polders, land reclaimed from the sea or lakes. The largest is Flevoland, an entire province that didn't exist until 1986. Think about that.
Okay.
The Dutch created their 12th province from scratch in living memory. The Zuider Zee Works, which created Flevoland, is considered one of the seven wonders of the modern world by the American Society of Civil Engineers. Rivers define the landscape. The Rhine splits into multiple branches as it enters the Netherlands, creating a complex web of waterways. These rivers have been both a blessing, trade routes, fertile soil, and a curse. Flooding. The 1953 North Sea flood killed over 1,800 people and prompted the Delta Works, a series of dams, sluices, locks, dikes, and storm surge barriers that's arguably the most sophisticated flood defense system on Earth. Climate-wise, the Netherlands has a temperate maritime climate. Think mild winters, average 3 degrees Celsius or 37 degrees Fahrenheit, and cool summers, average 17 degrees Celsius or 63 degrees Fahrenheit. Rain is a year-round companion. It drizzles about 200 days per year. The Dutch have a saying, we're not made of sugar, we won't melt. Umbrellas are for tourists. The locals just bike through it. Wind is constant, which explains both the historic...
See, I guess you would be accustomed to, you would be used to the weather for what it is. But I'm sure there might be some people out there that wouldn't want to get wet, but yeah, in those conditions, if you've lived all your life, you just, yeah, you would get used to it, I guess.
Tourists. The locals just bike through it. Wind is constant, which explains both the historic windmills and the modern wind farms. The Netherlands now generates about 15% of its electricity from wind, with massive offshore wind farms in the North Sea. The Netherlands packs 17.5 million people into its small territory, making it one of the most densely populated countries in the world at 423 people per square kilometer. That's denser than India or Japan. Yet somehow it doesn't feel cramped. That's Dutch spatial planning for you. The Randstad, a megalopolis including Amsterdam, Rotterdam, The Hague, and Utrecht, is home to about 8.4 million people, making it one of the largest urban areas in Europe. Amsterdam, the capital, has about 920,000 residents in the city proper, but the metropolitan area houses 2.5 million. Rotterdam, Europe's largest port, has 650,000 people. The Hague, Den Haag, the seat of government and international justice, has 550,000. Utrecht, the rapidly growing central hub, has 360,000. The Dutch are famously tall. The tallest people in the world, average height for men is 183 centimeters, 6 feet, and women average 170 centimeters, 5 feet 7 inches. Yeah. Scientists debate why. Genetics, dairy consumption, or natural selection in a flat country where you need to see over things. Nobody knows for sure. Ethnically, about 76% identify as Dutch, but the country has become increasingly diverse. Major immigrant communities include Indonesians, Surinamese, Moroccans, Turks, and more recently, Poles and other EU nationals. About 24% of the population has at least one parent born abroad. Life expectancy is excellent, 82 years on average. The healthcare system consistently ranks among the world's best. It's universal, efficient, and based on mandatory insurance with government regulation. The Dutch economy is a powerhouse disguised as a small country. With a GDP of about 1.1 trillion US dollars, the Netherlands ranks as the world's 17th largest economy. Remarkable for a nation of just 17.5 million. GDP per capita, around 63,000 US dollars, placing it among the world's wealthiest nations, similar to Denmark or Sweden. The Netherlands has been a commercial hub for centuries, from the Dutch East India Company, history's first multinational corporation, to modern-day Rotterdam, Europe's busiest port. Here's what'll blow your mind. The Netherlands is the world's second largest agricultural exporter, after the United States. How?
That's big.
Greenhouses.
Like, I don't need to talk to you. We don't need to mention how big United States is. So they come in after that. That's pretty impressive.
Agricultural exporter. After the United States. How? High-tech greenhouses, precision farming, and agricultural innovation. They export 120 billion euros worth of agricultural products annually from a country smaller than West Virginia. Major industries include high-tech systems, chemicals, oil refining, food processing, and logistics. Dutch companies like Shell, Unilever, Philips, ING, and Heineken are global giants. ASML, based in Veldhoven.
Those are some big names right there.
ING and Heineken are global giants. ASML, based in Veldhoven, makes the machines that make computer chips. They're literally the only company in the world that can make certain chip-making equipment. Amsterdam is a major financial center and home to the world's oldest stock exchange. The port of Rotterdam handles 470 million tons of cargo annually. Schiphol Airport is Europe's third busiest for cargo and a major passenger hub.
Cost of living varies dramatically. Amsterdam is expensive. A one-bedroom apartment in the center costs around 1,800 to 2,500 euros per month. Okay. A beer? 5 to 6 euros. But smaller cities are more reasonable.
That's me doing the currency conversion from euros to Australian dollars.
And salaries generally match the costs. The Netherlands consistently ranks in the global top 10 for quality of life. Work-life balance is sacred.
Hey.
Most people work 36...
They look like they're having fun. They look like they're having fun right there.
For quality of life. Work-life balance is sacred. Most people work 36 to 40 hours per week, yeah. And part-time work is common and socially accepted. The yeah. official language is Dutch, spoken by 23 million people worldwide. Frisian is also official in Friesland province. But here's the thing. 90% of Dutch people speak English, and they speak it well. Many also speak German or French.
Yeah. See, through videos, especially, I like to do these ones, which are like educational. I've done some funnier ones, but yeah, where I just, it gets onto my knowledge more about Netherlands. It's a big reason for making videos on this channel. But like, it's those things I've picked up before. What did he say again?
Frisian is also official.
Oh, no, yeah, the English from other countries that aren't a naturally like English-speaking country, like, yeah, Dutch obviously is the main language. They still understand English very, very well. I picked up on one of the earlier videos that, yeah, they're right up there, if not the best, that's a non-English-speaking country.
In Friesland province.
They can understand it really
well. Here's the thing. 90% of Dutch people speak English, and they speak it well.
Well, how that happened. Let's just roll through that again.
The official language is Dutch,
yeah.
spoken by 23 million people worldwide. Frisian is also official in Friesland province. But here's the thing. 90% of Dutch people speak English, and they speak it well. Many also speak German or French. You could live in the Netherlands for years speaking only English, though learning Dutch opens social doors.
Yeah, of course.
The Dutch are famous for their directness. They'll tell you exactly what they think.
Yeah, I heard that as well.
No sugarcoating. This can shock visitors, but it's not rudeness. It's honesty and efficiency.
I like
that. Time is valuable, so why waste it on pleasantries?
Oh, that's good.
Cycling isn't just transportation. It's a way of life. There are 23 million bikes for 17.5 million people. The cycling infrastructure is unmatched. 35,000 kilometers of dedicated bike paths.
Wow.
Cabinet ministers bike to work. Everyone bikes. Kids, grandparents, people in suits, in dresses, carrying everything from groceries to furniture.
Looks ready for like the weird and wonderful? The Netherlands has a village called Giethoorn with no roads, just canals and footpaths.
Wow.
It's called the Venice of the North.
That's kind
of
cool.
And mail is delivered by boat. Orange is the national color, despite not being on the flag. It comes from William of Orange, the founding father. During King's Day, or football matches, the entire country turns orange. The Dutch eat more licorice per capita than anyone else.
Wow.
2 kilos per person per year. And not just sweet licorice. They love the salty variety that most foreigners find disgusting. There's a tradition called uitvaaien, literally to blow out, where you go outside in windy weather to clear your head. The Dutch have turned bad weather into therapy.
Ooh, I like that. Like, I know that can be possible, but it's... Yeah, I liked how that it's a common thing. Okay.
There's a tradition called uitvaaien.
Like that it's an actual tradition. It's not something someone does or a few people do just personally as... Yeah, you might do that. Like I do that sometimes, but it's actually a proper tradition in Netherlands.
Salty variety that most foreigners find disgusting. There's a tradition called uitvaaien, literally to blow out, where you go outside in windy weather to clear your head. The Dutch have turned bad weather into therapy. The Netherlands has more museums per square kilometer than any other country. There's even a museum dedicated to cheese, one for bags and purses, and another just for fluorescent art. The country has 1,281 bridges in Amsterdam alone. Venice has fewer than 400. Yet somehow Amsterdam isn't known as the city of bridges. The Netherlands is a parliamentary democracy and constitutional monarchy. King Willem Alexander is head of state, but his role is largely ceremonial. Real power lies with the democratically elected government. The Dutch political system is based on consensus, the famous polder model. With proportional representation, no single party ever wins a majority, so coalition governments are the norm. Forming a government can take months of negotiation. The country has numerous political parties spanning the entire spectrum.
I know that one, it said something about racism and discrimination.
Negotiation. The country has numerous political parties spanning the entire spectrum. Recent years have seen fragmentation, with new parties emerging regularly. The Netherlands hosts several international organizations. The Hague is home to the International Court of Justice, the International Criminal Court, and over 200 other international organizations. It's earned the nickname International City of Peace and Justice. The country consistently ranks among the least corrupt in the world. Citizens have high trust in institutions, and civic engagement is strong. Tourism in the Netherlands attracts about 20 million international visitors annually, more than its population. Amsterdam is the obvious draw. The Canal Ring, UNESCO World Heritage, the Anne Frank House, the Rijksmuseum, Van Gogh Museum, and yes, the Red Light District. But Amsterdam is both the best and worst of Dutch tourism. Incredible history and culture, but also over-tourism. The Kinderdijk Windmills, another UNESCO site, showcase 19 historic windmills in a polder landscape.
In Netherlands, there is actually a lot to see. You'd be quite busy as tourist.
It's the Netherlands of postcards and paintings. Kokenhof, open just 8 weeks each spring, displays 7 million flower bulbs. It's the world's largest flower garden and absolutely spectacular. The Zaanse Schans offers a glimpse of traditional Dutch life with historic windmills, wooden houses, and craft demonstrations.
Just this part here with the windmills, just, I guess that's the effect of windmills. Like, it just looks really peaceful. This scene here, seems really peaceful.
It's touristy, but beautifully done. Rotterdam showcases modern Netherlands. The cubic houses, the massive Erasmus Bridge, cutting-edge architecture, and Europe's largest port. The Hoge Veluwe National Park proves the Netherlands isn't just cities and polders. It includes forests, heathlands, and the Kröller-Müller Museum with its sculpture garden and Van Gogh collection. The Netherlands proves that size doesn't determine significance. This small, flat country below sea level has engineered not just its landscape, but its entire society into something remarkable. Prosperous, tolerant, innovative, and sustainable. From conquering the sea to pioneering social progress, from golden age masters to modern tech giants, the Dutch have consistently punched above their weight. It's a country that turned its greatest challenge, water, into its greatest strength. So, have you experienced...
I love that. Like, something that could have been a negative thing, it's... Yeah, they take it in their stride and, turn it into something positive. I like that general kind of meaning. And people that can do that, or a country that can do that.
Its greatest challenge, water, into its greatest strength. So, have you experienced the Netherlands beyond Amsterdam's tourist track? Biked through the countryside? Let me know in the comments below. And if you enjoyed this deep dive into the Low Countries, give it a thumbs up and subscribe for more geography and culture content. Thanks for watching, and tot ziens. See you in...
It went in a different direction. I wasn't sure which direction it was going to go in, but it was it turned out to be very, very positive towards Netherlands. I feel like it's saying as the country that shouldn't exist, it went a bit deeper than that. Okay, I really enjoyed it. Like at the beginning, how they said was a third that's underwater. But yeah, it really was a bit deep. I felt we were just learning, or I was. I was learning, and some details that I've heard from other videos before, as it'll generally happen as I keep doing more. But it was more just about learning those key pieces of information about Netherlands. So as I said, I remember saying it during the video, I like these type of videos, the educational ones, and just, where it adds on top of my Netherlands knowledge with, more videos I do. So if you've got any others you'd like me to react to and learn from, let me know in the comment section, and subscribe to the channel for more Dutch videos, reacting to Dutch videos. As I said, new little setup now, so I'm ready to do some more reactions. So I'll see you in another video.